In this Cakewalk tutorial, I'm going to look at aux tracks and buses. So I'm going to look at what they are, what the differences between the two are, how you can use them, and I'll give some examples of when you might want to use aux tracks and buses. And they're a lot easier than what it might sound, and they can take your music productions to the next level. I'm Zane. Welcome to Audio Tech TV, where it's my goal to help you conquer the tech so you can unleash your creative beast. Now let's get into this Cakewalk tutorial. All right, so I'll just do a quick explanation of what an aux track is and what it can do and what a bus track is and what it can do. So I have an aux track right here, this bass lows. It's an aux track, and it looks very similar to the audio track. You can actually put audio clips into an aux track. You can record into an aux track if you really wanted to. And really, it behaves a lot like an audio track, and it shows up along with your audio tracks in the track view here and on the same side in the console view. So the big difference between an aux track and an audio track is that you can easily route audio to an aux track. It's not as easy to do that with an audio track. Now with buses, you can see we have some buses over on this side here, and they show up on this side of the console. They do not show up in your track view here. And because there's no track here, we can't put any audio clips into it. We can't record into it. They're really just designed for routing audio to them. And you can route multiple tracks from here to a bus. And then you can even route a bus to an aux track or another bus if you wanted to. So their main job is just for routing audio, and that's what a bus is. So that's kind of the difference between a bus and an aux track. So now let's look at creating an aux track and how we might use one. So I have this acoustic guitar here. It's a very plain acoustic guitar. Now say I wanted to send this to like a reverb or something like that. I could easily go into the console view here, click on sends, the plus sign here, and then go down to new aux track. And you can see it's created a new aux track called aux 1. We can change the name of that, and I'll just call that acoustic reverb. All right, so it's acoustic reverb. We're going to make that bigger just so I know what I'm working with here. And we'll put a reverb onto this track here. All right, so I have my reverb effect on this track here. I don't have one on the main acoustic track. So let's just listen to what both of these sound like together. And the cool thing is if you solo your main track and it's routing audio to an aux track, it's automatically going to play that aux track with it. So you don't have to solo both of them. So let's just listen. But if I mute the aux track, you just hear the regular track. And if I mute the regular track, you don't hear anything because we are going post fader. You can see that here. By default, it's always set to post fader. But if we click on that, and now if we hit play, you just hear that acoustic reverb track and not the main track. So that's one cool thing that you can do with an aux track. And the reason why you might want to do this is because now we're getting the full signal of our acoustic guitar sent to this track. It's not being affected by the levels over here or anything like that. So that's the way I want to send this right now, is pre-fader. So I'm just going to unmute that. We'll play our track again. And you can see I can just adjust the volume of the reverb now. I don't have to adjust the level of our main track, just our reverb right here, which is kind of nice. And now if we really wanted to, we could send both of these to a bus. So let's look at creating a bus now. So what I want to do is go down to our console here. And if you don't have the console view open, say it looks like this, you can easily go up to views and click on console view. And that's going to bring it up. So now what we want to do is go down here where it says master. It has this O here. You can see it's on every track. This is your output. So we want to change the output from the master. we want it to go to a new bus. So let's create a new stereo bus. And we can see over at the end over here, we have bus G, it's called. And we'll just change that to acoustic bus. And now we know what we're going to be controlling with that. And we want to do that for both of these tracks. So we want this one also sent to our acoustic bus. But you'll notice now that acoustic bus is already in our bus list here. So we don't have to create a new bus. We just click there. Now they're both being sent to that. Let's give that a listen. And you can see I can control the volume level of both of those together by using this bus. I could also add effects onto the bus if I wanted to put compression to both of those together, kind of blend them together, maybe EQ them together, something like that. I could do that here if I really wanted. And another thing that we could do is route this to another aux track if we really wanted to. I'm not sure why you'd want to in this instance, but there are times where you might want to take the audio from a bus and then route it back to an aux track and then maybe route that to another bus, something like that. You can get as complicated with these as you want or keep it as simple as you want. I try to keep things as simple as I want, but you can see we have a send here. We can do that. Now, if you wanted to, you don't have to use the sends to use aux tracks. So I'll just go to another track. I'll take this tambourine right here. I'm going to unsolo this, go to our tambourine, and I'll solo that track. We'll just give that a quick listen. So this is our tambourine. It's very basic. So say we wanted to send this to a bus or an aux track, but we don't want to use the sends feature. We just want all of the main audio from this track to go to an aux track or to a bus, not through the sends. We're not going to split it or anything. So what we're going to do is just go down to the master like we did before with the buses, and we could choose this, then new aux track, and then we could call that Tambo Aux. And there are times where you might want to do this. Now, another use that I always use a bus for is my drums. So we'll just have a look here. I have my drums in a folder, and it's the Easy Drummer plugin that I'm using here. But I have them routed to individual tracks. So the kick is on its own track, the snare is on its own, etc. Everything's on its own track. Then I have all of these tracks outputted to my Easy Drum bus over here. So everything gets sent through that bus. I'm just going to solo that and unsolo this, and I'll show you what it looks like here. So we can see the levels on the individual tracks and over here on our Easy Drum bus. And you can also see I have a parallel here, which is a drum parallel. So I have this drum bus sent to the drum parallel here, where I do some compression on there to really squash it and kind of beef up the drum sound. There's lots of uses for aux tracks and buses, and they can really take your music productions to the next level and make them sound a little more pro and just thicken things up a bit. Now, if you want to check out even more Cakewalk tutorials, click the video on the screen right now or click the one under it to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Audio Tech TV, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.